One more example from practice set we'll take now. That is the sixth example. Which set of numbers could be the universal set for the sets given below? See the first part. A is a set of multiples of 5. B is a set of multiples of 7. And C is a set of multiples of 12. So you know the multiples means what? Multiples of 5, that means 5, 10, 15, 20 and so on. It is an infinite set because there is no other condition that wherever this set will end. So there is no ending. Multiples of 7, so set B will have the elements 7, 14, 21, 28, 35 and so on. And C is a multiple of 12, so 12, 24, 36, 48, 60. If you know the tables, very easily you can write at least 4 to 5 elements can be written. So now all these sets belongs to what? See, all these are natural numbers. They comes in the set of natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, infinite. All these elements are coming in a set of whole numbers and all these numbers comes in a set of integers also. So here we can say that universal set for such type of sets ABC will be either a set of natural number, set of whole numbers or set of integers. So N will be the universal set, W may be the universal set, I may be the universal set. Similarly, if you see the second example, P is a set of integers which are multiples of 7. Now multiples of 7 are what? 7 ones are 7, 2s are 14, 7 threes are 21. In the same way, they have given the condition integers, so negative numbers also will be included. 7 minus 1s are, 7 minus 2s are, minus 14, 7 minus 3s are. So these are also the multiples of 7, minus 7, minus 14, minus 21 and so on. So here infinite sign I have put and here also. Similarly, T is a set of the even square number. Now you know that square of the even number is even and square of odd number is odd. See, for example, 1 is odd number, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, both are even. 3 square is 9, both are odd. 4 square is 16, both are even. So even number, complete square means 4, 16, 36, 64, 100 and so on. So these are the square of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, in that way we can write. So what will be the universal set? Now if you see, P is a subset of integers. T is a subset of integers. So here we can say that they are also the subset of integers. Now if we are considering only positive numbers, that means if P is a set of multiples of 7, then you can write 7, 14, 21, 28 and so on. Now you just check that seven, 14, 21, 28, if we consider only positive multiples, and T, 4, 16, 36, all these are natural numbers, all these are whole numbers, all these are integers. So what will be the universal set? Here also N, W and I. N means set of natural number, W means set of whole number, I means set of integers. Now in this way we can say that U is the universal set. Now children, you have already studied the numbers up to the real numbers. What do you mean by real numbers? In real numbers, irrational and rational both are included. Now, rational numbers means what? In rational numbers, this set of natural number, whole numbers, integers are also included. So always remember that N means natural numbers is a subset of whole numbers. Whole number is a subset of integers. Also, if you see, integers are also the rational numbers. If we consider that integers is a subset of rational numbers, that is Q, and this rational and irrational together form the real numbers. Now if this is the condition, then here you can say that set of rational numbers is a universal set. But this rational and irrational numbers, irrational, I am writing only I, are irrational numbers, they belongs to the set of real number. And here we can say that real number is the universal set. Also, the numbers which are rational cannot be irrational, and numbers which are irrational cannot be rational. That's why Q is a, here we can say that Q and Q dash, Q means set of rational numbers, then Q dash will be set of irrational number which are the complements of each other. Please mind this well, Q and Q dash, how it is? Because rational cannot be irrational and irrational cannot be rational. They are complements of each other, and the universal set is real numbers. Did you understand? Now we'll see the operations on sets. In these operations of sets, we are going to study about the intersection of two sets, then disjoint sets and union of two sets. Let us see first intersection of two sets. I have written one example here. Set A consists of elements 1, 3, 5, 7 and set B 2, 3, 6, 7, 6, 8. Now check these elements. Is there any element is repeated in both the sets? Yes. If you see, 3 is the element belongs to both the sets. Now we are writing these sets in the form of Venn diagram. Then set A, for set A one circle, for set B another circle. But as 3 is common in both the elements, we must have some common portion. So circles are intersecting. So see this left side circle, set A consists of elements 1, 3, 5 and 7, and B also consisting of 2, 3, 8 and 6. Means 3 belongs to A and 3 belongs to B also. So A intersection B is what? 3 only. So A intersection B will consist of one element, and that is 3. Now if we want to define the intersection set in this form, how we can write? If A and B are any two sets, then A intersection B will be equal to what? A intersection B is a set of all X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. See, the word and is very important here. Means element should be present in A and it should be present in B also. Then we get the intersection. And if there is no any common element in both the sets, then the intersection will be the empty set or null set. Now, disjoint elements. Whenever this element intersection of the sets has no element, that means null set, then they are called as disjoint sets. See this A 1 3 5 7 and B 2 4 6. Is there any element common in these two sets? No. So set A is written separately 1 3 5 7, B is written 2 4 6. That means no common element, so there is no intersection. So here we can say that A intersection B is null set. See, this is the symbol for null set, and then they are called as disjoint sets. Now we'll see the union of two sets. Suppose A and B are two sets whose elements are minus 1, minus 3, minus 5 and 0. These are the elements of set A. 0, 3, 5, 7, 8 elements of set B. Then union means what? Union means what? Altogether this A and B are considered, but repeating elements we are not writing two times. Only one time we have to write. That means minus 1, minus 3, minus 5, 0 all are written. But 0 is repeated in both the sets, so it returns once only. Then 3, 5, 7, 8. So here you can see that A union B is minus 1, minus 3, minus 5, 0, 3, 5, 7, 8. So union set, how you can define? The union set is a set of all X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Here the word or is very important. Children, see the difference between and or and or. And means here in the intersection the element should be present in A as well as B. But in the union set, element should be present either in A or in B. That's why here or written. So in this way, these operations you have to keep in mind. For intersection of two sets, see the symbol which is shown over here. And for union of two sets, this is the symbol we are using. Okay? The next concept of this chapter is number of elements. Number of elements means what? For example, A set consists of 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. These are the elements. Just count these elements. So there are 5 elements. That means number of elements of set A are 5. So N of A is written as 5. See, number of elements, how it is written? Small n and in bracket the name of the set. N of A is equal to 5. Similarly, set B has elements 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36. So N of B is 6. Now here I am continuing this with the help of previous concepts which we have studied, that are intersection sets and the union sets. Now if we consider this before union, we'll just add this N of A and N of B. So it will be 5 plus 6, 11. I'm just giving the number 1 over here for this statement. Now let us write A union B means what? Union set means what? The element is belongs to set A or set B. So 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Now see 6 is repeated, so we are not writing that. Then 12 is also repeated in both, so that is also not written. So after that 18, 12, 30 and 36 are written. Now if you see number of elements of union of A and B, then it will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So N of A union B is what? We are getting it 9. Then A intersection B, if we consider, then it is 6 and 12 means only 2 elements are there. That means here N of A union B is equal to 9 and N of A intersection B is equal to 2. Let us see the addition of these two. A union B and N of A union B and N of A intersection B is equal to 9 plus 2, that is equal to 11. Now if you see this statement 1 and 2, their right hand sides are equal, that means their left hand sides are also equal. So N of A union B plus N of A intersection B is equal to N of A plus N of B. And this statement we can write from statement number 1 and 2. So we get this statement N of A union B plus N of A intersection B is equal to N of A plus N of B. Now if we want to find out N of A union B, then this N of A intersection B is shifted on other side. So N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. This is the formula or the relation we get, and this you have to keep in mind. Doesn't matter if you remember this previous relation and if you are using it while solving the problems. We'll take one example here. It is from practice set 1.4. The first example, if N of A is 15, N of A union B is 29, N of A intersection B is 7, then N of B is equal to how much? Let us write the formula first. N of A union B is equal to N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. Now substitute the values. A union B is given 29, N of A is 15 plus N of B we have to find out minus N of A intersection B is 7 given to us. So 29 is equal to this 15 minus 7 is 8 plus N of B. So N of B will be equal to what? 29 minus 8, and 29 minus 8 is equal to 21. So N of B is 21. You have to highlight the answer in the rectangular box. Okay. Now let us solve the word problem, which is based on either formula or this Venn diagram. Venn diagram is easy to solve the word problems. Children, you can see the word problem given in practice set 1.4, page number 16. First, I am just reading it. A survey was conducted to know the hobby of 220 students of class 9th, out of which 130 students informed about their hobby as rock climbing and 180 students informed about their hobby of sky watching. There are 110 students who follow both the hobbies. Then how many students do not have any of the two hobbies? How many of them follow the hobby of rock climbing only? And how many students follow the hobby of sky watching only? Now children, in this problem, if you see the number of students, total number of students are 120, and number of students having hobby of rock climbing 130. And in the question it is given, how many students are having the hobby of rock climbing only? So try to understand the meaning. Similarly, number of students having hobby of sky watching, that is 180 given, and we have to find out only sky watching students are how many, because the students who are having the hobby of rock climbing and sky watching, some out of these students, some of them are having both the hobbies also, and that students are 110. So if we want to draw the Venn diagram, then first of all you can draw the rectangular shape for the universal set, and that universal set is consisting of how many students? 220. So n of u is equal to 220. Now if we see that, if we are considering the set A, means number of students who are having the hobby of rock climbing, they are 130, and the students who are sky watching, they are 180. So here number of students are having the hobby 130, that is the first hobby, and second hobby is sky watching, number of students are 180. Now 110 students have both the hobbies. So what we have to do? The students who are having the hobby of the first one, that is rock climbing, 130, only rock climbing will have 130 minus 110, and that is equal to 20. And from this set B, the number of students, total number of students who are having sky watching hobby, that is 180, but out of that 180, 110 have the another hobby also. So minus 110, that is equal to 70 students will have the hobby of only sky watching. Did you understand this? Now we have to find out the number of students who are do not have any of the hobby. That means this remaining part, how many elements are there, that we have to find out. We'll just consider as x. So you can write here, let the number of students do not have any hobby be x. Now children, see this 20, this 110, then 70, and this x, this complete total should be 220. So from Venn diagram directly we can write 20 plus 110 plus 70 plus x is equal to 220. Now if you add all these numbers, what you are getting? 110 plus 70 means 180. 180 plus 20 is 200, plus x, that is equal to 220. So x is equal to 220 minus 200, and that is equal to 20. So now the answers are ready with us. How you will write the answers? Just see how many students do not have any of the two hobbies, that answer will be 20. Now how many students have the hobby of rock climbing only. Now A is a set of rock climbing, in that 130 students are there. From that 110 students are subtracted because they are having the another hobby also. So only rock climbing hobby, that will also be 20. And the number of students who are having the hobby of sky watching only, that is 70. Because here 180 students are there, but 110 are included in another hobby also. So only sky watching students are 70 students. And in this way we can solve this word problem. Now children, we have seen all the concepts of these sets. We have solved few examples from each and every practice set. And similar examples are given in problem set also. So now you practice the problem set, which is based on the concepts you have already learnt. So we have completed this first chapter, sets. Thank you.